as of tomorrow, I will be married for 19 years. Boom. Haters said I couldn't do it. I didn't know. Ohio just proved it again. The Republican Party is Donald Trump's party. Make no mistake, Trump's endorsement of J.D. Vance in the Ohio Republican U.S. Senate primary was the reason the author and first-time candidate wound up winning the nomination. As he has done many times before, Ron DeSantis, I'm looking at you, Trump reached down into the middle of a Republican pack, plucked someone out, and drove them to victory.
They wanted to write a story that this campaign would be the death of Donald Trump's America First agenda. Ladies and gentlemen, it ain't the death of the America First agenda.
What's new about Vance's endorsement and win is that they didn't come with Trump as president at the zenith of his political power and influence. He isn't president these days, after all, breaking news. What Trump is the first incumbent president since George H.W. Bush to lose his bid for a second White House term. And after his party had, in quick succession, lost its majorities in the House 2018 and the Senate in 2020, due in large part to Trump's unpopularity in the country at large. All of which brings me to a line from a speech Maryland Governor Larry Hogan, a potential 2024 Republican presidential candidate in his own right, recently made at the Ronald Reagan Library out there in California.
A party that lost the popular vote in 7 out of the last 8 presidential elections and that couldn't even beat Joe Biden is desperately in need of a course correction.
Now, any, and I mean any, objective analysis of the state of the Republican Party in the wake of Trump's presidency leaves you with this. The party needs change, and fast. And yet, Trump remains, and not just remains, but prospers, in spite of the fact that he both oversaw and bears responsibility for the fact that Republicans are shut out of power on both ends of Pennsylvania Avenue currently. And let's not forget, Donald Trump also happened to encourage and inspire the violent riot on January 6th that led to the invasion of the U.S. Capitol in hopes of stopping the counting of the Electoral College votes. This is a man that, by all the usual political measures, should be viewed with scorn by his party. Go back to George H.W. Bush, who I mentioned earlier, and think about him in 1993. No one, and I mean no one, within the Republican Party was taking marching orders from George H.W. Bush, nor was he seen as the de facto nominee for the party against Bill Clinton in 1996. Far from it. He was, in fact, seen as a failed president and not someone that Republicans wanted to be too closely associated with. Sidebar. Bush's presidency has been viewed better in the light of history. He's generally seen and rated as a middle-of-the-pack president. So, why has Trump managed to retain his stranglehold on the Republican Party despite an electoral record that suggests mostly, well, failure? Well, the most obvious answer here is that Trump has never conceded that he actually lost the 2020 election. Instead, he spent the past 18 months insisting, despite all evidence to the contrary, that there was widespread election fraud that cost him a victory.
The simple fact is the presidential election was rigged and stolen.
Because Trump has never acknowledged defeat, he, and let's be honest, many of the people who support him, still act as though he is the president. And some even believe he may be reinstated at some point in the future. See, if you never admit you've lost, it's a whole heck of a lot easier to be seen as a winner, even when all the available facts point to you being, well, a loser. Larry Hogan's plea to change course, then, is very likely to fall on deaf ears in the Republican Party. Nothing yet has convinced the Trump base that their guy lost and that changes are needed in the party. And it's hard to see Larry Hogan as the messenger who finally gets through to them. Plus, Republicans are positioned to have a very good 2022 midterm election. People are unhappy about the state of the economy and the fight against the coronavirus, and they blame largely Democrats who are in charge of the White House and Congress for it. And if Republicans do retake the House and Senate majorities this fall, and that is the likeliest outcome, you can be sure that Donald Trump will be front and center taking credit for those gains. Lost in that conversation, of course, will be the fact that the main reason Republicans were even in a position to need to take back the majorities in both the House and Senate is because they lost them under Trump's watch. Won't mention that. It's a remarkable trick that Trump has pulled. He is the Pied Piper of the Republican Party, leading the base wherever he wants it to go. And that is the point. We make new point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.